Hello Pirates, this is Yun for the Hunted Tips of the Plunder Pirates. This video is going to be handling about the defense layout called Encompassed Buildings plus the Double Fence. On my previous defense layout strategy videos, I have introduced about the Encompassed Buildings and the Double Fence independently. But today's video is about combining these two strategies to one. So just think about it, it's going to be quite effective because you're having the two layouts into one. So it's going to be more effective and I'll show you very soon. Okay, now let's look into the defense case 1, and when you see my defense log, you can see that there's about like 41%, 42% of damage. And somebody might say, isn't that too much damage for a strategy, the defense strategy, but anyway, you have to sacrifice the encompassed buildings. And mostly the encompassed buildings does not have that much gold or that much rums inside it, so anyway, you have to sacrifice to make your main base very safe. When you see carefully at this movie, you can see that there are two witch doctors. That means this guy is really for this attack. But anyway, you can see that the Dragonarts are already splitted and they're going apart and they're circling around. And what's good about this layout is that try to keep in the range of the cannons. So what happens is that when they finish circling around and when they arrive at the end of this power hole, what happens is that they're not going to have any energy left to attack the main base. This is the point. And that was the end of the story. The Dragonarts arrive at the end of the base, but there's no energy, so he's dead. Now let's go for the second case. So this is quite similar attack from the others, but he came from the left side. So let's try to find out with this 42% of damage, what happened in this story. When you see carefully that, you can see that he's gonna be coming from 9 o'clock. You can see that a lot of troops are arriving from the corners. The reason why he's trying to attack from the corners is that because at each side there are a lot of cannons, so he's a little bit burdened about that, so that's why he's trying to come from the corner side. But what happens is that though you come from the corners, because of the encompassed buildings, they're going to be circling around anyway and they're going to be splitted. And now he's trying to enter the power hall, but as you can see there's a lot of cannons attacking the guys coming to the middle, so he's already having a lot of damage, so not that big damage for this case also. Okay, now let's look into number 3, today's last case for the defense. And what happened is that when you see the defense log, it was about like 34% of damage. So when you see carefully that, you can see that there's a lot of bombers and juggernauts and heavy gunners. So it's going to be quite hard to defend these kind of troops. So when you see carefully, they're going to be deployed at the 2 o'clock side. So they're coming from the sides. And I think what he was thinking was that he thought he's going to deploy a lot of bombers so he could break down this double fence. But what happens is that because of these encompassed buildings, they're circling around instead of breaking down the double fence. So this is the bait. This is the point. So I think I just got it right. So now they're splitting apart and circling around. And it's very, very easy to defend these kind of splitted troops. As the encompassed buildings are within the reach of these cannons, you can see that while they're circling around encompassed buildings, they're going to be damaged, and this is going to be a very effective way to defend your base. So try to combine these double fence and encompassed buildings, and it's going to be a very effective way to defend your mainland. Thank you for watching, and if you love my videos, try to please click the honey jar at the 2 o'clock to subscribe for further updates. Thank you for watching.